Hi, I'm artist Wayne A. Brown, and this is my studio, and I'm going to be starting on a painting today, and I thought I'd show you how I paint, how some of these paintings I have done, such as, you know, these guys here, and how they all kind of came about being made. I don't really do sketches for my paintings sometimes, not with Canva Whispering. Canva Whispering is a different technique for me, and I really enjoy it. It really just is very expressive. So, basically what we're going to start with is I take a canvas. Here we have a nice big fella. What I did is I started by painting blue. Now, this blue has been applied by my palette knife, as you can see. If I can get you in there. And so it's pretty much just a mixed shade of blue. Painted in with my palette knife. And so basically what I do after I do that is I look at it and I see an outline. I see shapes. I see what I see in the canvas. And it kind of just pops out in my brain imagination. And I just kind of make it happen. So today we're going to work on that. So here you see this. And you're going to see what I do from there. So we're going to set you right down here. Nice view of the canvas, and I'm going to come over here and we're going to start painting. And we're not going to get the whole thing done today, that's going to be obvious, so in case you're curious. This is going to take a while. It's a long process, sometimes a week, sometimes a day, sometimes a couple days, sometimes maybe even a month or two. So I'm going to sit here in front of my canvas here, and I'm going to set this up, put my coffee down. And put the top down, I'm going to secure a little bit. Now, like I said, I see some shapes here, and I'm going to start by bringing those out a bit more. So, since it's blue, I'm going to pick some colors that I think will work great. And I'm going to start with some deep violet, because I like deep violet. Violet's a nice color, especially against this blue, should be really good. I'm going to take a little bit of that, and I'm going to put it on my palette. I'm going to do a lot more, because it's going to fill in a lot of this canvas. And I'm going to take a little black, just a little couple drops, not much. I'm going to take some of my primary blue, what I have left, see if I have another tube. Let's see. Oh, you know what? I think I'd rather go with this. Oh, here we go. Cerulean. No. French ultramarine. That's the one I want. Give me some French ultramarine. Ooh la la. Baby the French. Viva la France. Huh? Not really, but it's cute. I'm going to put a good amount in there. Now I'm going to take my medium fluid, which is basically just glue and water, but it works great for my paint, my acrylics. Let's get this little down here a bit more. Even it up because it's a little awkward and I don't know why. Someone's been tripping on my canvas here. In fact, you seem a little crooked here, so we'll straighten out there. There we go. Okay, now like I said, I see some very interesting shapes in here. I'm going to add a little bit on there. I'm going to take my palette knife. We're going to mix this together, get that blending color. And it's going to be like a very dark purple blue. That black's going to really darken it a bit, and I'm loving it already. There we go. I'm just going to like this. Go ahead and mix that in. We want that nice, rich color. Oh, that's beautiful. See how beautiful that looks? That's going to look beautiful. That's going to look very nice. Now, this is the color palette I'm going with. It's what I'm seeing. So, there's no There's no right or wrong way to paint. You're the artist. It's your expression. It's your communication. So we want you, to devise that. And let me find a nice, ooh, that's a beautiful brush right there. I like that brush. That's nice. That's going to work fine for me. I believe it will. Okay. So, we have a brush. We have our colors mixed in. Let's do a little painting, shall we? That may not be the color. Let's go ahead and try the brush. First thing I'm going to do is grab this color over here and put it back up in the pile. Okay. Now, I'm seeing just applying some paint here. Trying to pick in. That's nice. Blend it all down in there. Get some nice strokes. Start off short. And just start painting it in. Nice long strokes. Let me see here. So you just want to kind of follow what you're seeing. The canvas is telling me right now what it wants painted. So we just kind of go ahead and get this painting to life. It wants, you know, no gender conforming, no political bullcrap, no political outrage, all this and that. I'm really, we're better people than that, I think. At least I hope we are. I'm trying to be a better person than that. Hope you are too, because better people make a better world, right? So, excuse me. So now I'm just gonna finish. Somebody's getting all fussy out there. Hope it's not my dog. So let's see. I'm just gonna paint it in there. And I'm following the shapes that I'm seeing originally in my imagination. So I'm just gonna go ahead and go with that. Nice. I see. Get that color in there. It's giving us the separation. And as I'm doing this, I'm seeing more and more come alive for me. So and these are just rudimentary geometric shapes. letting the painting build itself up here. Let's see. Where are we going with this? Just gonna go ahead and blend that on in here. This is helping to define our shapes. This angle right here. Brush, because it is not working for me that well. I can't find my art rag. And as you can see, I'm starting my building here. I'm going to take my more comfortable brush here. And I am building in. Let's see one right there. Let's go ahead and throw that in. Now, I have no idea what this is going to look like at the end of the painting, but it's starting to form into something right now. I don't know if you see it, but I do, and that's a good thing. Evenness to it. How's that looking? Pretty cool, huh? So, start something over here. I want
Interesting.
And now we have a pretty cool looking composition building up here with this skyline building in up to the side. I'm liking the way this is looking. Let's see how I'm going to pull all this together. Let's see. Speak to me, canvas. What would you like me to do? What's next? Go ahead and get this color in here. I'm just going to go ahead and fill this in. See how I want the rest of this composition with this dark shadow in the fill in. I'm not sure where I want to go with it yet, but she'll tell me in time. Paintings love to tell you what they think. I don't know, I just want to keep a little dot there. Let's just go ahead and fill this in here. That's a composition here. And this is the beginning of my painting. I'm not sure exactly what it's going to turn out to be in the end, but keep posted. You'll see it. There's a lot more to go. I like to get the sides of the canvas sometimes. Helps keep it blended in. So basically anything where it's going to be touching the edge, I just think it get on the side. It's fun. Okay. So yeah, we're just gonna tighten this edge out a bit more. Kind of want a bit more of a solid color on this side. That's what it's saying to me. Nice solid color. Now, the solid color is creating, and see how faded this is, gives it a distance. This is more foreground. So by being more solid, like it is, it really is drawing your eye to that separation. So it's creating some depth right now by doing that. So that's a good thing. Otherwise it'd just be a flat painting. We don't want flat. We want life. Life is not flat. Life is bumpy, edgy. You know, fun. So I'm just gonna go ahead and over there. More darker down in here, some. Just short strokes, sometimes long, sometimes short. They're your strokes, you divine, redevelop them. You find what makes you comfortable. You do what you do. A bit more solid down in here. Getting a bit more depth with it. Now, by doing it, I'm also, as I'm putting in these solids, I'm like thinking, okay, where's the light source? Where's my light source coming in here from? Quite frankly, I'm not 100% sure yet, but we'll get there. Take your time. Let it develop on its own. You're making the painting. It's making itself a little bit. You know, we're getting a little bit of some depth in here. Yes, Father.
Well, I just wonder if it's getting lit.
Yeah, I know, I'm getting there. Hang on. Go right ahead. Hopefully I can edit that out. Never ending. All right. Okay. And seeing a bit more darker depth in there, right there, like that. There. Let's get a little bit over here. Filter so I can. I got paint. I got some leftover paint, so we're just gonna go ahead and use it. Waste not, want not. Just kind of blotting it in, putting it into the canvas. A little bit over here. Solid right there. I'm just gonna continue this path because it's creating a nice range of darkness and light. You can see just a little bit of depth and some textures developing here, and I love that. Love that. So we're gonna go on and keep playing with that. I'm just gonna keep dipping this in until I'm satisfied because I'm the artist. Okay. There's my composition. All right. Now we have the beginning of a painting. You can see what it's looking like now. Kind of a bit of a cityscape kind of feel to it. It's not a city I know. It's just abstract. I just created that from just looking at the canvas and letting it speak to me. And I call that canvas whispering. Thanks for joining. Have a great day.